Hello, my name is Soham Ghosh, a student of Computer Science and Engineering Department of Thapar University, and this video is about the summer training that I did from Center for Development of Advanced Computing, Mohali, under the guidance of Mr. Vijay Kumar. So let me give you a brief introduction about CDAC. The Center for Development of Advanced Computing is a premier research and development organization of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology for carrying out R&D in technologies like IT, electronics and other associated areas. It was initially set up in 1988 to build supercomputers due to the denial of the import of supercomputers by USA. The primary focus of CDAC has changed since then. It now focuses on cloud computing, cultural computing, open source technologies, and providing training to students like us. So, the name of the project is Network Design Proposal for a University. So, this is the entire network for the university. Let me take you through each component step by step. The first one is an internet service provider. ISP contains three servers, SMTP, DHCP and HTTP, which in turns are connected to a switch and which are then again connected to two routers. The internet ISP provides gets connected to a router which is situated inside of the campus. Now, from this router, a switch is connected, which is connected to a PC and a server which is administrated by the network administrator. Up next, we have the reception area. In the reception area, there is a reception PC, a director's office laptop, and a limited access Wi-Fi for all the visitors. Next, from the main router, we have a switch which are connected to five different routers. Each router is representing a different department. For in the case of computer science department, the first switch is connected to another switch, which in turn is connected to a department head and a professor's PC. Now, for the sake of simplicity, I have assumed and I have shown that one PC for each department head and one laptop for professor. However, there can be any number of laptops connected to the switch. From that, we have another switch connected which have two different labs, the lab 1 and lab 2. Each lab contains two PCs for sake of simplicity. Now, each lab is connected to a VLAN. The first one is VLAN 100 and the second one is VLAN 200. Similarly, the another department, that is the mechanical department, has same setup for a department head and professors. Likewise, for the electrical department, for the civil department and the chemical department. So, up next, we have the guest house. The guest house contains two PCs and a limited access Wi-Fi for all the visitors. Now, for the hostels, I have connected the router to a switch, which in turn is connected to two different routers. The first router is connected to a set of switches, which are connected to two type of PCs. The first one is for a warden, the second one is for all the students. The boys' hostel contains three different hostels, Hostel A, Hostel B and Hostel C. Similar network design is implemented for girls' hostel having two hostels, Hostel D and Hostel E. Up next, we have the staff buildings and director's residence. So the router is connected to a switch and switch is then connected to another switch which connects to the director's residence. Now, director's residence can have any number of PCs, but just like earlier times, I have only depicted only one PC. Now, for the staff residence, I have connected this switch to a router, and then routers are connected to two different switches, which are in turn connected to the PCs. The staff building contains staff building A and staff building B. Up next we have the library. The main router is then connected to a switch which in turn connects a number of PCs. So this is the entire design for the network design proposal for a university. So this is the network topology diagram as I have described in the earlier scene. The tools used for creating this project is Cisco Packet Tracer. It is a free software provided by the Cisco for educational and training purposes. The key highlights of this projects are creating an ISP, creating a network administrator, interconnection between various departments, creating VLAN, providing network access to library and guest house, providing an open Wi-Fi for guests. To make sure that a device is connected to a network, we can ping the IP address with a 32 bit of data. So it says that 4 packets were sent and 4 were received, lost is equals to 0. This means this device is connected to the network. However, this can also be seen with these green lights which indicate that yes, this device is on the network. If in case a device is not on the network, then these green lights get turned into orange. Now in order to demonstrate how this network performs, I'll try to use the network simulation tool in the Cisco Packet Tracer to demonstrate a transfer of packet from a sender to receiver. Now, the transfer of packets will be solely based upon the forwarding decisions made by the switch and the router. Switches will use a MAC address table, whereas routers will use a IP routing table. So this is the network administrator device and this is the reception device. Now, we're just going to send the packet. This step signifies that we are sending the packet from sender to receiver. Now, once we have sent the packet to the receiver will send a response to the sender that yes, it has received it. Now it shows successful. Thank you.